By default, when you open a new document in Microsoft Excel, the grid lines are visible as well as the row and column headings in your display view. You can turn these on or off by going to your Page Layout tab, and within the Sheet Options group, you have two categories, one for grid lines and one for headings. Now, the default setting for your screen display, or how your worksheet appears on your screen, is to have the grid lines turned on as well as the headings turned on. But if you wanted to turn off your grid lines and your column and row headings for the screen display, you can do that by deselecting these two options. Now, be aware, if you turn your grid lines as well as your row and column headings off, it can be very difficult to know where you're at in your spreadsheet. The only indication that you have of where your active cell is up here in the name box where you have the cell reference. And notice as I click around, the cell reference changes. So it's usually a pretty good idea to keep at least your headings turned on in a display view for your worksheet. I'll go ahead and toggle both the grid lines as well as the headings back on in this new worksheet. Now, your printed hard copy of your document will be a little different than the settings that you have for grid lines and headings for your display view. Notice that by default, those settings for printing grid lines as well as headings are turned off in Microsoft Excel. But you can turn them on so that when you print a hard copy of your document, you will have grid lines as well as your row and column headings. Let me go ahead and show this by opening up a new spreadsheet. This is called Ribbon 2, and it will give us a little bit of something to work with. Here I'm going to go ahead and turn off my grid lines in my display view of this document. And then if I come over here to my Office button and select that and pull down to Print and Print Preview, let's take a look at how this will look when it's printed. Notice that there aren't any grid lines, as well as the row and column headings are not going to appear. Let me go ahead and close Print Preview. And now notice if I turn my grid lines on for print, as well as my print option for headings, that will turn my headings on for the printed document. So let me again come back here to the Office button, select that and pull down to Print and Print Preview. And notice that now in my printed document, I have my grid lines as well as my row and column headings. I'll go ahead and close Print Preview. Let's go ahead and apply what we just learned about grid lines and headings to our product list. So go ahead and access or open your product list. And if you'd like to start with a clean start file, you can do that by opening up 0607 start file in your Excel 2007 course directory in the Chapter 6 directory. I'll go ahead and open up the 0607 start file. Let's go ahead and select our menu tab, and what I'd like you to do is go ahead and turn off the grid lines in your display, as well as make sure they are turned off on your print view of the Raspberry Brigade menu product list. So with the Raspberry Brigade menu product list opened and visible on your screen, come up here to grid lines and under the view option, deselect that to turn them off. Let's go ahead and keep our headings turned on, and notice that our grid lines as well as our headings are both turned off, which is the default setting for Excel 2007. To double check that, come up here to your Office button, select that, pull down to Print in Print Preview, and let's see how it looks in Print Preview. Notice that there's our menu, no grid lines, no column and row headings. Everything's looking as it should at this point. Go ahead and close out a Print Preview so you're back at the worksheet, and save your file, and I will catch up with you in the next movie.